records are out today. Just listen. Ah, it's so peaceful.
So this is all that I'm using at the cabin. It is just a 100 watt Harbor Freight solar panel setup. Pretty much comes with everything that you need, minus the battery and a couple little things like the inverter and stuff. But for the most part, it's a really good deal. And you know, for most like an actual homestead, 100 watt system is not nearly enough for what you would need. But for something like we're trying to do, and come out in the woods in a small cabin, being able to just charge the laptop up or run some lights is more than sufficient. The rest will be, you know, obviously the heating will be done with a wood stove, and the stove is done with propane. So this little 100 watt system actually works fairly decent and gives us more of a charge than actually what we need.
So as you could probably tell, I'm on the roof of the cabin right now, and it's obviously, it's all tin. It's all recycled tin that I got. I got it for nothing. Like I said, so I wanted to touch a little bit more onto the solar setup, mainly because a lot of people that are gonna watch this video are gonna be like, geez, 100 watts, that doesn't seem like hardly anything. Everybody has their own perspective of it, you know. A lot of people want all the same amenities and the same luxuries that you get from a normal house, but to not rely on your normal utilities. Where for us, going off grid is more of a way to become closer to nature, you know? Personally, I debated on even getting solar panels to begin with because I kind of like the feel of just simple candles and radiant lights. But you know, I figured if we're gonna do any of the YouTube stuff, or you know, you want to keep the phones charged and stuff like that, you know, just getting something small like this, like the 100 watt Harbor Freight solar kit, would be plenty sufficient.
Alright guys, so let's go inside so I can show you how simple the setup is for those of you that might be interested in the Harbor Freight solar panel setup. Okay, so I got two lights that came with the setup. I ran one here, and I ran the line across the beams. I got the other one here, and then I just ran my lines down. Now the panels set directly above this window here, and I fed it in. I got stuff in the way here. I kind of hide it so you can't see it, but I fed it in through the wall right here. Okay, this is my inverter, which I had to buy separately. It was fairly cheap. I want to say it was in the $40 range. And here's the unit that tells you, that comes with it, that'll tell you your voltage that you're reading. Right now I'm at 13.7. But yeah, so I just bolted that to the wall. It's as simple as the wires are already, I mean, they're dummy proof, to put it to you that way. You just hook a wire in each panel. Each wire from the panel hooks into one specific wire. That one specific wire I ran down through the hole into my control box. And from here, these two plugins here, each one is for a light, which I showed you. And my my inverter runs back through the same hole and connects to the battery. So we have two different hookups onto the battery. And so to simply turn my lights on, I just hit the switch. And that's it. and they give off a ton of light. I mean, for this little cabin, way more than what's needed. I usually keep one of them off at nighttime, and I'll leave the one on above where I'm cooking. That's pretty much how I place the lights, one for above where the stove is, and the other one above where the table is, where we eat and play cards or whatever we may be doing. But yeah, guys, that's really it for this solar panel setup. Super, super simple. I recommend it to anybody that's going to do any RVing, even just doing like a week-long camping trip or something small like this, like a small cabin in the woods. Works perfect. If you're not trying to run washers and dryers and this and that, you know, it'll work perfect. I even run a TV off of it. Now, this TV has been used once in probably the past 6 months. But just for those cold, rainy nights where there's nothing to do and you get the urge to feel like you're at home a little bit. Yeah, so all you would do is then click on your inverter here. And let's see here. Okay, you hear it powering on. And voila. We got TV. And for the TV, I'm just simply using a analog box. Which I also run up through past these wires up in the corner there, and it's free TV. You get like 20 channels, which is more than sufficient. Like I said, if it gets used once every 6 months, it's done its job. But now during the daytime, even with this Harbor Freight panel set, the only 100 watts, I can run this TV continuously all day, and it charges faster than what is required power wise out of it. So it actually still charges while it's on. Nighttime, I got a couple batteries. You could probably get 6 to 8 hours if you ran this all night, but we're never gonna do that. But yeah, I mean, so for what we need this solar setup for, it works great, and I highly recommend it. It's a good price and it works good.